All right, everybody, welcome back. So let's work through these. Charles, what are you thinking for this first one?
I'm thinking I should write a program and just run it through because that's the easiest thing to do.
So what you're saying is this f function is so kind of wacky that it's hard to imagine actually analyzing it and doing anything with it. But on the other hand, the space of x values is very small.
Right.
Good. So right, so we can enumerate all the different possible values and just see which one gives the highest output.
Yeah, that's pretty straightforward if I just wrote the code. In fact, it's like one line of code.
So I wrote it for you.
Oh, good.
I'm nice that way.
You are that way. You optimized our time.
I did. So for what it's worth, this is what the function looks like.
I'm not even sure that's a function.
Isn't that beautiful?
It's something. It looks like DNA gone wrong.
Yeah, totally wrong. Like there's just mutations everywhere. Or it's like a bow tie that then tried to tie itself in another dimension. I mean, like you can see there's this sort of interesting up and down ness to it, like the sine wave part, but it, like they're interdigitated with each other. It's just crazy. It's really nice.
Interdigitated. That is an
Yeah,
awesome word.
it means to put your fingers together. So
So what happens if you plot that but with connecting lines?
oh hee sure. You
Wow.
get something like that.
Wow.
This is a kind of unfriendly function.
Yes, it's not the friendliest function I've ever seen. Although now it looks a bit like a, actually looks a bit like an insane bow tie.
Nice. Electric bow tie.
Yeah, it's kind of cool.
So it turns out that there's two points that are really, really close to being the top. There's this one at 11, and there's this one, I don't know, a little bit after 80 or so. But the one at 11 is actually the largest.
This function goes to 11.
It does indeed. So I'm going to say 11. I wanted to make a crazy function. That was the first thing that popped into my head. Actually, I did the second one was a mod 3 at first.
Well, it's an interesting thing, right? Because if you try to reason this out, it would be very difficult to do. I mean, first off, mod isn't very nicely, you know, it's very easy to, it's not very easy to deal with algebraically, right, in closed form. But you could start reasoning and say, well, the dominating factor is mod 7 in the sense that you're never going to be greater than 6. And then, of course, the mod 6 is never going to be greater than 5. So the best you can get there is 5. And then you minus the sign, which is going to be some small number. So you can kind of pick all the values that are going to give you something like 5 there. And then whichever one has the smallest sign, that's the one you go for. I wonder if that would get you anywhere close to the right answer. So interesting that that's not quite true here because 11 mod 6 is, no, 11 mod 6 is 5, right? So, squared is 25. Mod 7 is 4. Is that right?
Anyway,
Okay.
let's do the second one.
Okay.
All right, so it turns out that again, 11 and 80 are really close, but 11 is slightly larger, and it's just almost 5, but not quite. All right, so for the second problem, now we can't use the same trick of enumerating because our x's constitute the entire space of the reals.
So there's like 200 of them.
More even. So we need to do something else, and I think what you were pointing out to me is that because this is a nice polynomial, we can actually use calculus to figure out where the maximum is.
Right, just take the derivative and set it equal to 0.
So unfortunately, I made that a little harder than probably you'd appreciate. So the derivative would be this, and setting it equal to 0 would give us this equation, which unfortunately is a cubic.
Right.
So it should have three solutions, perhaps. And you could just check each of them, but solving the cubic is sort of a pain. I guess I could have been a little bit nicer.
You could have been.
Sorry
But
about that.
it all depends on what you're optimizing.
So how would you go about solving this now?
I would go on Google and I would look up how do you solve cubics.
Sure, that's not a bad idea. Any other things? Because it is nice and smooth, right? So let's here. Let me actually plot it for you. So here's the function, and I just plotted a subrange of it from -500 to 1,000. You know, you could ask, well, could it be that the maximum is actually someplace outside this range? Do you know how you'd answer that?
No.
So because it's a fourth order polynomial, like think of a quadratic. It's got
Right.
that one bump in it. A cubic can have as much as one up bump and one down bump. And a quartic, a fourth degree polynomial, can have an up bump, a down bump, an up bump, and then back down. So we're actually seeing all the activity here. Outside this range, it just plummets negatively. It can't turn around and come back up again. So because we can see the two bumps, we're good.
Okay.
And in this case, it looks like the bump that we want is somewhere between 500 and 1,000, somewhere in the 700 kind of zone. And, well, so one thing we could do, because it is really well-behaved, we can kind of zoom in on the function in that range.
Mm-hmm.
So there we are now zoomed in from between 500 and 1,000. We can see, okay, well, actually, it looks like the peak is maybe between 600 and 800, you think?
I'd say 700 and 800.
Between 700 and 800. All right, let's take a look at that. Ooh.
Mm.
Nice and pointy. All right, so 740,
how about 740 and 760?
So we really are kind of getting into the nitty-gritty here. So for the quiz, we accepted anything between, 745 and 755. But in fact, we can keep zooming in and we can use calculus and we can really hone in on what the tippy top is there. But that's not so important right now. We could also use something called Newton's method. Do you know Newton's method?
I remember it.
Newton's method says, let's guess a position like, 755, and use the derivative at that point, which is actually really easy to compute. It doesn't involve solving the cubic. It just involves writing down the cubic and evaluating at that point. We can actually, fit what the straight line is here, and we can take steps in the direction of that line. It's a gradient ascent kind of method.
Yeah.
And that'll allow us to hone in. As we get closer and closer to the top, the slope is going to flatten out. We're going to take smaller steps. And this process converges to whatever the peak is. I think it's a little bit under 750.
That looks about right.